亲爱的主内弟兄的弟兄姊妹，主日早上平安。
Dear brethren in the Lord, peace to you in the Lord this morning.
今天早上我要跟大家分享的信息是哥罗西书三章十二节到十七节。
This morning I'll be sharing with you from the book of Colossians chapter 3, verse 12 to 17.
信息的主题我定为基督徒的生活。
That the topic, I called it the lifestyle of the Christian.
我先把经文念给大家听。
I will first read this scripture for you all.
我先用中文念，然后 Ken 可以用英文念。
I will read in Chinese, and Ken can read in English.
所以，你们既是神的选民。圣洁蒙爱的人就要存怜悯恩慈谦虚温柔忍耐的心，倘若这人和那人有嫌隙，总要彼此包容，彼此饶恕。主怎样饶恕了你们，你们也要怎样饶恕人。在这一切之外，要存着爱心。爱心就是联络全德的，又要叫基督的平安在你们心里作主，你们也为此蒙召归为一体，且要存感谢的心，当用各样的智慧把基督的道理丰丰富富的存在心里，用诗章颂词灵歌彼此教导，互相劝诫，心被恩感歌颂神，无论做什么，或说话，或行事，都要奉主耶稣的名，借着他感谢父神。
Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 to 17. So, as those who have been chosen of God, holy and beloved, put on a heart of compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience.Bearing with one another and forgiving each other, whoever has a complaint against anyone, just as the Lord forgave you, so also should you. Beyond all these things, put on love, which is the perfect bond of unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ richly dwell within you, with all wisdom, teaching, and admonishing one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs,Singing with thankfulness in your hearts to God. Whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks through him to God the Father.
我们一起有一点祷告。
Let us pray together.
亲爱的阿爸天父，在这个清早晨，我们奉你儿子的名聚集在你的脚前。
Dear Abba Father, this morning we gather in the name of your Son.
我们用我们的心灵跟诚实来敬拜你。
We worship you in truth and in spirit.
我们祈求你的灵在我们每一个人的心里做工。
We ask that the Spirit work in each one of us.
好让我们的生命能够更多的彰显你儿子，我们救主耶稣基督的丰富。
That more in our lives that we can manifest the fullness of your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ.
奉主耶稣基督的名祷告。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
亲爱的弟兄姊妹，如果有人问你，一个基督徒最在他的生活里面最重要的事是什么？
Dear brethren, if someone came and asked you that in the life of a Christian, what is the most important thing?
你会怎么回答？最重要对你来说，最重要一个基督徒在你的生活里面。
How would you answer? Like in the life of a Christian, the most important thing. How would you answer that?
如果我们看圣经，整本的新约，甚至整本的旧约，我们可以有一个归纳。
If we were to look at the New Testament, Old Testament, the whole Bible, we could kind of have this summary.
我们可以说，我们基督徒的生活，我们的生命里面最重要的就是认识基督和活出基督。
that in our lives, the most important thing is that we can know Christ and to be able to manifest or live out Christ.
这个是一件事情的两面。
This is the two sides of the same thing.
我相信，我们可以从圣经里做出一个结论，我们必须要认识基督，我们才能活出基督。
That we can conclude from the Bible that we have to first know Christ to be able to live out Christ.
如果我们认识的基督越少，我们活得出的基督也越少。
If what we know of Christ is few, then what we can manifest of Christ is similar.
如果我们认识基督越多，我们彰显的基督也越丰富。
That the more we know Christ, then the more abundant is our manifestation of Christ in our lives.
所以我们看保罗书信的时候，保罗常常会在书信的前面，他告诉我们基督是谁，他做了什么。
And that's why in the letters of Paul, he often tells us who is Christ and what did he do.
然后但是在书信的后面，他会告诉我们，我们基督徒的生活应该是怎么样子的。
And at the end of those letters, he will tell us that this is how the life of a Christian should look like.
那哥罗西书也是同样的形式去，保罗去写这封书信。
That Colossians is written in the same format by Paul.
在这一段经文里面，十二节，他开始的时候说，所以你们，然后他说你们是神的选民。
So in the beginning of verse 12, it says, so, as those who have been chosen.
每一次当我们看圣经的时候，每一次出现所以的时候，我们都要去思考，就是前面他说了一些事，所以有这个后果。
So when we see the word so or therefore, we really need to kind of focus on what came before it.
所以前面他说了什么呢？他说，因为耶稣基督是包括一切，现在不算是不管你是犹太人、外邦人，这个是或外人、希古提人、受割礼的、未受割礼的，这些都不重要了。因为基督是包括一切，又住在个人之内，所以。
And so in the previous verse, it says that Christ is all and in all. And so whether you are Greek, Jew, circumcised, uncircumcised, barbarian, or Scythian, slave, or freeman, it doesn't matter because Christ is all and in all. And therefore, or so.
保罗甚至很可能他说的不单是上面的几节，他可能是说这本书信前面所有的经文里面。他所说到耶稣基督他的超越性他的丰富
and,
所以
and Paul may have even meant that not just the previous verse but all that was spoken previously about the supremacy of Christ and therefore or so
我现在要很快的帮弟兄姊妹做一个总结哥罗西书前面两章到三章的前上半保罗所告诉我们的基督的丰富。
And so I want to quickly do a review or summary of the previous two chapters as well as the first half of this chapter as to the abundance of Christ.
还有就是我们基督徒在基督里的丰富，一个是耶稣基督他的丰富，他的超越性。另一个保罗的重点，保罗有两个点，一个是耶稣他是超越一切的，第二点是我们在基督里的人，我们在他里面也得了这些丰富。
And so there's two aspects Paul talks about. One is the abundance that is Christ himself, and then the other part of his supremacy, and the other part is how we in Christ have also a share of this abundance.
在一章十五节到二十节，他说耶稣是在新造和旧造里面居首位的。
That in from in.Chapter 1, verse 15, it tells of how he's, all things are created through him. He's the firstborn of all creation.
在二章三节他说一切的丰富一切的智慧和知识都在基督里藏着。
In chapter 2, verse 3, that all of the treasures and wisdom of knowledge are hidden in Christ.
二章的九节他说神本性一切的丰富都在基督耶稣里。
that in chapter 2, verse 9, that the fullness of deity dwells in bodily form in Christ.
当他告诉我们神的一切的丰富，一切的智慧，一切的知识都在基督里之后，然后保罗他就转移，他就告诉我们，然后你们这些蒙恩得救的人，你们这些在基督里的人，你们也得了同样的丰富。
And when Paul speaks of the abundance, the hidden treasures of wisdom and knowledge that in him, that's in Christ, he turns around and says, and then you who are saved, redeemed, that you who are in Christ also have this abundance.
一章十三节，他救我们脱离了黑暗的权势，把我们迁到他爱子的国里。
In 1:13, that he tells us that we are rescued from the domain of darkness and transferred to the kingdom of the beloved Son.
一章二十七节，基督是我们荣耀的盼望。
Chapter 1 verse 17, that he is that all the hope and glory is in him.
二章十节，我们在基督里也得了神一切的丰富。
That we have in verse 10, that we have received all of his abundance.
二章十三节，神赦免了我们一切的过犯。
Chapter 2 verse 13, he has forgiven us of all of our transgressions.
二章二十节，三章一节，我们与基督同死同复活。
Chapter 2 verse 20 and chapter 3 verse 1, that you had died with him and we have also raised with him.
三章三节，我们与基督一同的藏在神里面。
Chapter 3 verse 3, that our life is hidden in Christ.
三章四节，基督是我们的生命。
Chapter 3 verse 4, that Christ is our life.
三章九节，我们已经脱下旧人，穿上新人。
Chapter 3 verse 9, that we have put off the old person and put on a new self.
十一节，基督住在我们里面。
Chapter 3 verse 11, that Christ dwells in us.
保罗让我们他用各种的各种的形容词图画，来让我们看见我们这些在基督里的人是得了何等的丰富。
Paul uses many ways of expressing how that in Christ that we have received all sorts of abundance.
当我读这些经文的时候，我心里充满着喜乐，充满着盼望，充满着感恩。
That when I read this passage, I was full of joy, full of hope, full of thankfulness.
我甚至预备讲章的时候，我停下来，我说感谢赞美神，在基督里，你给了我们这一切的丰富。
That I, as in preparing, I at one point stopped and I gave thanks because I said, "Oh, you have given so much abundance."
希望弟兄姊妹，你现在也能够多一点的认识我们在基督里所得到的丰富。
Brothers and sisters, I hope that you can take the time to recognize the richness that you have in Christ.
所以十二节说，他说，所以因为我们在基督里得到了一切丰富，所以我们应该有这样的生活。
And so in chapter 12 it says, therefore, or so, that because of all this, this is how we are to live.
如果没有基督，没有基督在十字架上所做成的功课，工作，那我们是不可能活出今天我们要交通的这些基督徒的生活。
If Christ did not die on the cross for us, that today we will have no way of living out this life.
他说，所以你们既是神的选民，圣洁蒙爱的人。
And so that you are a chosen of God, holy and beloved.
神的选民是旧约里面的概念，神拣选了以色列人，在万民万国当中，他拣选了以色列人。
This was the perspective of in the Old Testament that God has chosen the people, that out of all these nations, God has chosen this group of people.
现在保罗把这个同样的图画用在基督徒身上。
And Paul uses that same picture and puts it upon Christians today.
这里让我们看见两个点，一个是神主动的去拣选我们。
The first, we see two things. The first of them is that God himself actively chose.
所以我们应该有一个感恩的心去回应。所以下面保罗多次的说感恩的事。
So we have to be thankful and respond in thankfulness. That's what Paul mentions, thankfulness many times.
然后第二点，这里告诉我们，我们是属神的，我们是神的选民，我们是属神的。
And secondly, that we are a chosen people of God. We belong to God.
我们不再分犹太人、希腊人，受割礼的、不受割礼的。我们是在基督里，我们是合一的。我们是属神的选民。
That no longer are we Greek or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, but now we belong. We are one. We belong to God.
然后他说：“我们，你们是圣洁的。”
And he said that you are holy.
这个是我们的地位。当我们信主的那一天，我们就成为一个圣徒。我们有圣洁的地位。
That this is our position. That the moment we believe, that we become saints.
然后他说你是蒙爱的人。
And that he says that you are beloved.
耶稣意思说不是你，是不是你爱我，是我先爱了你们。
In John, 1 John says that it's not because you love me, but I first loved you.
当以弗所书四章说神有丰富的怜悯，因他爱我们的大爱，当我们死在过犯中的时候，便叫我们与基督一同活过来。神的大爱。
That in Ephesians it says that God being rich in mercy because his great love which he had love for us.
亲爱的弟兄姊妹，你知道你是被神所爱的人吗？
Dear brothers and sisters, do you not know that you are a person that's beloved of God?
你知道我神为什么爱你吗？
Do you know why God loves you?
神爱你是因为你很殷勤的读圣经，很殷勤的聚会，很殷勤的祷告吗？
Is it because you're diligent in reading the Bible, in fellowshipping, in prayers?
神爱你是因为你做许多的很有见证的事情吗？
Does God love you because you do many things that testify about Him?
不是。
That isn't so.
神爱你是因为你在基督里，是因为基督藏在你里面。
God loves you because you are in Christ.
我们的人是不可爱的。
That we as people are not lovable.
我们的衣行就好像肮脏的衣服，以赛亚说的。
That all the good deeds are like filthy rags in Isaiah.
但神拣选了我们，我们是神的子民，基督住在我们里面，我们与基督一同藏在神里面，因为基督他爱我们。
But because Christ dwells in us, and we are in Christ, and Christ is in God, that he loves us.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姊妹，不管你现在遇见什么难处，你要记得一件事。我们是蒙神所爱的人。
That no matter what difficult situations that you come across, remember one thing: we are people beloved of God.
他说：“既然你是蒙神所爱的人，既然你是圣徒，既然你是神的选民，那你的生命就要显出你是一个圣徒，就要显出你是基督徒。”
And so, because you're chosen of God, because you're holy and beloved, that you need to live out this life. You need to live out a life that is that of a saint.
他说：“你们就当存下面。”他说了：“怜悯、恩慈、谦虚、温柔、忍耐的心，五个性情。”
It speaks of five types of character: mercy, compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience.
当存要存，原文是要穿上。这个是跟前面他说你们已经脱下旧人，穿上新人，那个穿上是一样的概念。
And that the use the word put on here in the same way as as putting on clothing in the same way as putting on the new self.
New self, new man. 今天我们的主题可以说是基督徒的生活 ，Christian living.
So we could say that today what we're talking about is Christian living.
或者说新人的生活
，or the life of a new person.
这个穿上是跟前面第五节说要致死你们这些地上的犯罪的肢体，要在第八节里面他说要清洁一些罪恶，这强烈的对比。
That in we compare that to in the previous parts where in verse 5, where it tells you to put to death those things that are immoral, or in verse 8 where it says to put aside things like anger and wrath.
那这里他说的五种的性情，跟在加拉太书里说的圣灵的果子， 有是类似的。
And that these five characters are very similar, or they're very related to the fruit of spirits in Galatians.
这个是我们新人的生命的特点。
These are very distinct characters in this new life.
如果我们仔细去想这些特点
，If we
怜悯啊，有恩慈啊，有谦虚，有温柔，有忍耐。
If we think of those special distinctive things such as mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience.
当我们去思考的时候，我们就会其实我们会想到这些其实是主耶稣自己的心情。
That when we look at when we consider these five things, we realize that these are the characters of the Lord Jesus Himself.
当我们去思考福音书里所描述的主耶稣，主音福音里说。主耶稣看见这些羊，好像没有牧人。主福音书说，主怜悯他们。
When we look at the gospel books, how it describes the Lord Jesus, we see that when the Lord Jesus looked upon the people and they were like sheep without a shepherd, that he had compassion upon them.
福音书里刚让我们看见，主耶稣说，我是柔和谦卑的。
That in the gospel books, he says how gentle he is,
and humble.
腓
立比书二章也让我们看见，他本有神的形象，却不与神同等，不与神强夺，反倒虚己，取了奴仆的形象，成了人的样子。
In Philippians, we see that it said that he has had this attitude in himself, which is also in Christ Jesus, that who, although he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality of God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a bondservant. Because in verse 4 it says, Christ is our life, and so these aspects, these characters of God, need to be manifested through the Christian life.
然后他下面说，假如你和这些人和那些人有嫌隙，总要彼此宽容，彼此饶恕，正如主饶恕了你们一样。
And it speaks here of to bear with one another, forgiving each other, whoever has a complaint against anyone.
彼此有嫌隙，就是说，人与人之间，基督徒与其他的人，家人也好，弟兄姊妹也好，同事也好，有一些问题出现。
That when it says whoever has a complaint against anyone, it means that whether it be in the family, a church, or at work, that there's something not right between these two people.
弟兄姊妹，我不知道你的生命里面现在有跟谁。有一些问题。
Brothers and sisters, I don't know in today, like today, whether or not in your life you have any issues with another person.
你有没有跟你的丈夫或者妻子，你有一些事情你是过不去的，你还没有原谅他。
Is there anything between husband and wife that you have not been able to forgive one another?
是不是有一些弟兄姊妹，你觉得他得罪了你，你不愿意原谅他？
Has a brother or a sister done something to have offended you and you can't forgive them?
你是不是跟你的父母或者是你的同事有一些纠纷，你不能原谅他？
Have you had arguments with your parents or maybe with a coworker and you're unable to forgive them?
当保罗说人与这人与那人有嫌隙，就是说基督徒没有完全的活在这个基督的心情里面，如果一个人完全的是怜悯，充满慈爱，充满谦虚，充满温柔，充满忍耐，这个人应该不大会跟其他人有问题。
When Paul mentions that if there's people who have complaints against one another, but unable to forgive, then we have to realize that if a person can really express that the character of God, of Christ, that of mercy, of compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, I'm sure that there shouldn't be any issues there.
也就是说，我们是在被建造的过程。We are under construction.
And so, in other words, it means that we are still under construction, in the process of being under construction.
如果我们与人有嫌隙，我们还没有原谅人。保罗的劝勉说，你们要彼此的包容，彼此的饶恕。主怎么饶恕了你，你也应该饶恕别人。
And so what Paul tells us, if you have any complaints against one another and unable to forgive, he tells us to bear with one another, forgive each other, just as the Lord forgave you.
他说到包容啊，彼此包容就是，如果对方的一些意见或者做法跟我们不一样的时候，我们不要立刻去判这个说对方的罪或者是审判对方。我们要有一个包容的心，去思考究竟他的想法是什么，去站在他的角度去看一件事。
When Paul says to bear with one another, in a dispute where you think someone is wrong, to not immediately rush to judgment or to condemn that person, but rather to bear with another in maybe looking at it from their perspective.Looking from their point of view.
亲爱的弟兄姊妹，现在你的生活里面是不是有一些事情你不能没有包容你身边的人呢？
Brothers and sisters, in your life today, have you had to bear with another person?
你能够穿上这个基督的品格吗？去包容别人吗？
Have you been able to put on this characterof Christ, and that is to bear with the other person.
有没有什么人你是还没有饶恕的？
Has there been a person that you were unable to forgive?
你能穿上基督的这个品德饶恕这个人吗？
Are you able to put on this character of Christ and be able to forgive that person?
我们常常不能饶恕别人，就是觉得我们是对的，他是错的。
We can't forgive people oftentimes because we think that we're right and they're wrong.
可是你能穿上基督的品格，你能以恩典待对方，你去饶恕那个错的人吗？
But if you were to put on the character of Christ, and through grace to forgive the other person.
他说，主怎样饶恕了你，你也该饶恕别人，这个是一个对比。
And here, Paul tells us that just as the Lord forgave you, you should forgive them.
如果我们安静下来去思考，主怎么饶恕了我们？
When we sit quietly and consider, how did the Lord forgive us?
我们去思考我们的一生，我们做了许多污秽肮脏的事，是该死的事，是该被审判的事情。
That in our lives, the things that we have done that are bad, that deserve to be punished, to be judged.
在前面的几节，第五节，他告诉我们这些淫乱的事，淫乱啊，污秽啊，邪情啊，恶欲、贪婪，这些我们多多少少，我们有一点去犯这些错。
In verse 5, it speaks of immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, and greed, which we have all committed to some degree.
第八节他说的是恼恨、愤怒、恶毒，这口里说的肮脏话，就是我们用口去犯的罪。
In verse 8, it says anger, wrath, malice, slander, and abusive speech from your mouth. These are sins committed by our mouth.
我们的全人是污秽肮脏。
Our whole person is filthy.
但神看在耶稣基督的身上，他说：“你所犯的这一切罪，全部一笔勾销。”
But God looks at Christ and says, "Because of Christ, that all the sins you have committed, we are all erased."
究竟神赦免我们的罪，他赦免了多少？他能够，他有没有限度？
The amount of sin we have committed, and his forgiveness, is there any limit to it?
他是不是有一些罪很大，神不能赦免？
Are there some sins that are so great that God cannot forgive?
请看二章第十三节。
If you look at chapter 2, verse 13.
你们从前在过犯和未受割礼的肉体中死了，就是我们的活在罪里面，我们的灵死了。
It says in verse that you were, verse 13, that you were dead in your transgressions and the uncircumcision of your flesh. That the things that we have done before, we have died, we have been separated from.
但下面那一句是神给我们的应许，他说神赦免了你们一切过犯。
And the passage after comes is such a great promise that he made you alive together with him, having forgiven us all of our transgressions.
神赦免了你一切的过犯。
All, he's forgiven us of all our transgressions.
当我们去思考这个事的时候，我们怎能不感恩？
When we consider this, how can we not be thankful?
彼得有一次问主，主啊，如果有人得罪我，我应该赦免他多少次？
Peter once asked the Lord, if someone has offended me, how many times must I forgive him?
是七次吗？
Is it seven times?
主说不是七次。
The Lord says not seven times.
是七十乘七十。
It's seven times seven times.
也就是说
70 times, 7 times.
也就是说，我们要有基督的这个心肠，赦免、饶恕我们身边的人，不管是谁对谁错。
And that is that we need to have this heart where we need to forgive, regardless of who is right or wrong.
如果主耶稣是根据谁对谁错才赦免我们的话，我们今天会活在什么光景？我们以后会面对什么样的审判
？If the Lord forgave us based on who is right or wrong, we consider what kind of punishment awaits for us.
他说：“主怎样饶恕了你们，你们也应该怎么饶恕别人。
”The Lord says, Paul says that how the Lord has forgiven you, so you shall also forgive.
他说：“第十四节，在这一切以外，要存着爱心，爱心是联络全德的。”
Verse 14 says, beyond all these things, put on love, which is the perfect bond of unity.
这里原文里面是穿上，纯正爱心其实是穿上。
Again, the word used here is the word put on.
就是这个是爱是神，爱是基督，爱是基督的心情，我们要穿上，因为我们本来就是神的选民，是基督的人。
That Christ is love.And that this love could be, and that we need to put on this love of Christ.
他说这个爱啊，是在一这一切以外，所有的这一切以外，就是说我们的事情，神的一切品格里面最重要的事情就是爱。爱是一个把所有的品格连接起来的神的性情。
It says beyond all these things, as in like of all these characters, that this is the most important. This is the one overarching that combines all of these things together.
他说爱能够联络全德，或者翻译成可以把一切都绑得完全。
It says that it is the perfect bond of unity, as in it binds all these things together.
我们基督徒常常会因着我们对于圣经的理解不一样，我们会彼此有嫌隙，甚至我们会变成仇人。
Christians have some, many of us have different understandings of Scripture, and it sometimes sets us to complain against one another, even turns us into enemies of each other.
这些都是爱主的弟兄姊妹。
These are all people who love, these are all brethren who love the Lord.
当我们对于真理的理解不一样的时候，我们能不能够用爱的原则去彼此的包容，彼此的宽容
？And that when we all have such different understandings of Scripture, can we use the principle of love to bind us together, for us to bear one with one another, forgive each other?
如果我们不愿意赦免、饶恕别人的时候，我们就没有活在基督的爱里面，我们是活在苦毒里面。
That when we can't forgive each other or bear with one another, then we end up living in bitterness.
圣经多处的告诉我们，律法的一切的总纲总结就是爱，爱神和爱人。
That the Bible tells us the fulfillment of the law is love, is to love God and to love man.
基督的性情是忍耐的心。这个爱，这个哥林多前书十三章就告诉我们，爱是什么？爱就是忍耐。
And that, that the Lord is patient with us. And what does it tells us in 1 Corinthians 13 that love is patient.
我们看下一节十五节，他说又叫基督的平安在你们心里面做主。
Verse 15, it says, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts.
这个在我们心里做主意思就是做王掌权。
The meaning of rule in your heart is it is that of having authority, of ruling, of being Lord.
是谁掌权呢？亲爱的弟兄姊妹，你现在是你自己掌权，还是基督的平安在你心里掌权？
Well, we consider the word rule here. Are you ruling, or is the peace of Christ ruling?
要回答这个问题，你可以去思考，究竟我的生命里面，我是不是有一些人我没有去饶恕的？
To answer this question, you have to consider today: are there some people in your life that you are unable to forgive?
你知道你应该饶恕，可是你没有饶恕他，你放不下。
That you know you are supposed to forgive them, but you don't. You are not you are unable to let go of it.
如果你有这个问题，那你的心里就会有一个不平安，因为基督的平安你感觉不到，他没有在你里面做主。
If that's the case, that today you in your heart you will not have peace, because the peace of Christ is not ruling.
让基督的平安在我们心里做主。
May the peace of Christ rule in our, and be Lord in our heart.
这个平安，圣经里说，我们原本与神为仇的，现在因着耶稣基督，我们与神和好了，我们与神有 shalom， 有平安。
We were formerly enemies with God, but today we have shalom, we have peace with Him.
这个平安是基督徒的记号，就好像爱心一样。
This is the symbol of the Christian.
以弗所书四章说到这个基督身体的合一，他说你们要以和平的彼此联络，竭力保守圣灵所赐合而为一的心，和平。
Then Ephesians 4 tells us that we're to be bound with the peace, with the peace of God.
他这里很可能保罗就慢慢去想到是一个教会的彼肢体之间的问题，因为他说你们是为此门造归为一体。就是基督的身体。
Paul may have saw this as a problem within the church, that there were some issues there, but he tells us that this is, we are to be in a perfect bond, we were called into one body.
这个肢体有一个原则，这个原则就是基督的平安，在每一个肢体身上做主。
That this one body has this principle, and that is that the peace of Christ.Be Lord.
他说且要存感谢的心，为什么要感谢？就是因为我们在基督里，我们承受了这么多的基督的丰富，我们怎么不感谢呢？
So the next thing is to be thankful. When we consider how we have experienced all of the rich abundance of Christ, how could we not be thankful?
基督赦免我们的一切的过犯，我们怎么不去感恩呢？
Christ forgave us for all of our transgressions. How could we not be thankful?
我们怎能去抓着别人的一点的对我们的过错，那我们就不愿意赦免他呢？
How can we grasp hold of how a person has maybe offended us, but we're unable to forgive them?
下面他说十六节。当用各样的智慧把基督的道理丰丰富富的藏在心里面。
In verse 16 it says, let the word of Christ richly dwell within you.
这个是说到教会的生活，基督身体的生活，它上面是说到神话语的功用，下面是说到诗歌的功用。
It speaks of the life of the church.Of the Christians to have that word of Christ be with them, and then afterwards it speaks of how of the use of hymns.
关于神的话语，我们自己可以观察到三个小点。
That in In talking about the Word of God, we can see three aspects.
第一点就是他说要用各样的智慧把神的道，这个道理就是道 Logos， 把神的道丰丰富富的存在心里面。
The first thing is that the Word of Christ, the Logos, has to richly dwell within you.
中文把那个彼此教导好这个放在这个灵歌的后面，另一个可能的翻译是彼此教导，其实是指在上面那个神的话。
And that here when it talks about admonishing one another with psalms in the Chinese, it's very likely to be talking about the Word of Christ.
Teaching, admonishing and teaching.
Admonishing and teaching, sorry.
Yeah. 大部分的英文翻译的比较好。
Usually the English translation is a little bit more accurate in this regard.
今天我们看到三个点，一个是神的话语要教导神的话语，他说要用各样的智慧。
And that in the teaching of the Word of Christ, it says that you have to be used of all wisdom.
也就是说，我们不只是传达一个信息，不是在教导一个教书。
That we're not just teaching some facts.
Yeah, facts, or 或者是真理，我们要有智慧的去传讲真理，就是传递的方法、时间、口气。要有智慧。
It's a teaching of fact or truth that we have to do with wisdom and how to get it across.
如果你是教五岁小孩子的，你要用这样子的方法跟他传递神的话，教导他。如果你是跟一个四十岁信主三十年的肢体教导，你要用那一个不同的方法，同样的真理去教导他。
That if you're trying to teach a five-year-old, you'll do it in one way. But if you're teaching someone who is a 40-year-old person who has been with the Lord for many, many years, you use a different way, but the same truth.
这个我们如果有恩典做父母的，我们会有同感。要教一个我现在的孩子是八岁，要教一个八岁关于神的事、基督的性情啊，真的是。我觉得自己非常的没有这个能力跟智慧，所以向神求，求智慧。
If you ever had the grace of having children, then in my case, I have an 8-year-old son where I need to try to teach him, and I don't know how, so I pray that God gives me wisdom on how to do so.
这个教导，它的目的是什么呢？
This teaching, what is the purpose of it?
他说彼此教导，其实保罗在前面，他已经告诉我们保罗，当他说到他是一个传道人的职分的时候，在第一章里面的时候，他就告诉我们神，一章的25节，我是教会的执事，要把神的道理传得全备。
So when Paul talks about teaching, he mentions in chapter 1 verse 25, of this stewardship from God that he used to fully carry out the preaching of the word.
那我们去看28节，他能那里告诉我们，我们传扬他是用诸般的什么？是智慧。主耶稣这个保罗他传讲神的道，他知道他需要从神来的智慧。
In verse 20, he tells that when you teach every man, he is with all wisdom. Paul's saying that this wisdom is from God.
他说要劝解个人。
It is to admonish every man.
教导个人。
Teaching every man.
然后他告诉我们那个目的是什么。
And he tells us the reason for his teaching.
要把个人在基督里完完全全的引到神面前。
It is as to present every man complete in Christ.
另一个我们能观察到的就是他说要把基督的话丰丰富富的藏在我们的心里面。
Another thing we need to observe is that it is that the word of Christ to richly dwell within you.
诗篇119篇说啊，我们愿意把神的话深藏在我们的心里，好让我们不去得罪你。
Psalms 119 tells us that we're to put the word of God in our heart that we may not offend God.
我们希望能够把神的话成为我们生命的一部分，好让我们 面对生活各种各样的挑战的时候，有神的话来引领我们。
That may the word of God dwell in us, so that whatever problem that we may face in our lives, that the word of God may lead us through it.
所以，我们不管是做父母的，在教会做教导的，在不同的场合，神给我们有恩典，能够影响别人的，我们需要向神求智慧。
That whether it be at home, whether it be serving with brothers and sisters, that may that we pray that the wisdom of God be with us.
他说，就算彼此劝勉，也要有智慧。
And that we are to when we are to bear with one another, we are to have wisdom.
Admonishing
one another, we have to have wisdom.
是不是有时候我们劝勉别人，如果我们没有智慧的话，我们去劝勉别人，这个去鼓励别人，安慰别人，可能变成去指责别人。
That when we try to admonish someone or encourage them, and we don't do it with wisdom, then it seems like we end up condemning them.
原本我们是想把他拉到神这边，结果我们把他越推越远。
That we wanted to bring them before Christ, we ended up pushing them away. So we pray that that God will give us wisdom.
十六节，现在他说到诗歌，用诗章、颂词、灵歌彼此教导，互相劝解，心悲恩感，歌颂神。
Verse 16 tells us to admonish one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, sing with thankfulness.
这里我们至少可以想到两个观察的内容。
There are two things that we can observe here.
一个就是这里提到了几种的诗歌。
Here it speaks of several types of hymns.
可能诗章是说到诗篇里的诗，颂词可能是我们的所谓的 hymn。
It speaks of songs, as in our book of Psalms, or maybe talking about hymns, such as the hymnals.
或者灵歌可能是一些其他的诗歌，属灵的歌。
And spiritual songs may be just other types of songs that we can sing, that are spiritual.
但我们可以观察的就是，用多种格式或者多种形式的诗歌，能够帮助我们更丰富的去歌颂我们的神。
And so what we see is that there are various formats of spiritual songs that we can use to praise God.
我们根据我们属灵生命的阶段，或者是我们的环境，我们可能有时候这一类的诗歌能够帮助我们更多的去敬拜神。有时候另一种诗歌在那个时候，那个地方，那个环境能够帮助那边的弟兄姊妹更多的去敬拜神。
That maybe in this part of my spiritual life, that these hymns can help me come close to God. And in another part of my life, in a different place, these other songs may be what's helpful for me.
所以观察的第二点就是，我们应该常常的尝试，在个人的灵修，在家里的敬拜，在教会的敬拜，我们用诗歌，各样的诗歌，去赞美这位配得赞美的神。
And that for us, we consider, whether it be at home, whether it be in fellowship, that we can have all kinds of hymns that we can use to praise God with.
好，现在我们要说到十七节，这里可能是保罗的对这一段的一个小节，一个总结。
That we look at verse 17, and maybe that this is kind of the conclusion for what Paul is trying to say.
无论做什么，或说话，或行事，都要奉主耶稣的名，借着他感谢父神。
That whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks through him to God the Father.
这里说到一个我们常常说的事，就是奉主耶稣基督的名。
There is this here speaks of something that we often speak of, which is due in the name of the Lord Jesus.
他说，无论你做什么，你说话，你做东西，你就要奉主耶稣的名。
And here speaks, whatever you do in word or deed, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus.
就是说，我们生活里面，不管你去上学，不管你去在家里做家务，或者在你的工作场所去服侍客户，或者在教会聚会，或者在 你跟家人相处。
So whether you are studying, whether you are doing chores at home, whether you are working and serving others, whether you're in the church.
不管你是跟谁说话，跟你的孩子说话，还是跟你的上司，还是跟弟兄姊妹。
Whether you're speaking to your child, to your peer, to your boss.
不管我们生命里面，我们的生活里面。做什么事，说什么话，我们都要奉主耶稣基督的名。
That whatever we do, whatever we say, that we do all in the name of the Lord.
那这个是什么意思
？What does this mean？
我相信他不是说到表面里说，就是口里说，我奉主耶稣的名。
It is not something where you just kind of say in your mouth like, "Yeah,、oh, I do this in the name of the Lord."
如果是这样的话，我的孩子每一次上课。我奉主耶稣的名去聚会、去上学。我每一次碰到一个人，我奉主耶稣的名，我现在跟你说话。然后我做这件事，我奉主耶稣基督的名扫地。
So does that mean, oh, you go to school? You say, I in the name of the Lord, I go to school. In the name of the Lord, I do this. Or in the name of the Lord, I'm going to sweep the floor.
我想，我们可以口里说，但我相信保罗或者圣灵里更重要的重点是我们的心。
I think, what Paul was saying, or what even the, what the Spirit is saying, is that, what's important is our heart.
当我们做一件事情的时候，我们所做的事，或者是我们说话的时候，是不是高举主耶稣基督的名，或者是我们做了这件事？我们会羞辱主耶稣基督的名。
And rather, in what we say, what we do, is do we do it to lift the name of the Lord Jesus, or do we bring shame upon the name of the Lord Jesus?
也就是说，每一次我们决定我们生活，或者是我们生命的路程，我们要做任何的决定，我们要去思考：我做了这件事，我是高举基督，还是？当别人看见我做这个事，他们发现我做这个事，我会羞辱耶稣基督的名。
So it means that in our lives, when we make this decision of whatever we say or do, is it one in which when that is going to lift the name of the Lord Jesus, or is it one that will bring shame upon him when other people see what we say or do?
亲爱的弟兄姊妹，可能你现在生命里面，你就要面对一些选择。可能有中学生要毕业了，要选择大学。
There may we may all be in different places in our lives, but for example, what if you are a student and you're making a decision now and you're going to go to college?
可能你是大学生，你要毕业了，你要选择工作，或者你要选择要不要去研究院。
Maybe you're in college and graduating and deciding whether work or whether you're going to continue your studies.
或者现在经济不景气，你或者你被裁员了，你要决定下一份工作，下一个地方，我要去哪里？神要带我去哪里？如果有选择，我应该怎么选择？
Or maybe because there's the downturn right now, maybe you lost your job and you're now looking for a job and you say, well, where am I supposed to go? God, what do I do?
圣经神很有智慧，他没有把所有我们人生所面对的所有事情的细节全部写在圣经里面说，你遇到这个事情你就这样子做，遇到这个事情你就这样子做。
God has lots of wisdom, and he didn't tell us in the New Testament, based upon this situation, this is what you do, or that situation, this is what you do.
因为神所启示的，它是一个基督生命的原则。
Because what God has revealed to us is
the principle
of Christian living.
这个原则可以用在2000年前保罗写给哥罗西的这个哥罗西教会里面。
That this principle is one that extends from 2000 years ago when Paul wrote to the brethren at Colossae.
也可以用在中古时期的欧洲。
And it could have been used in the Middle Ages in Europe.
也可以用在21世纪美国的奥兰多。
And it could be used in 21st century America in Orlando.
今天我们所分享的是一些，保罗 经过圣灵的感动，说让我们可以有一些去镜子对照我们的生命，是不是有彰显基督丰盛的生命。
Today we can use what we're talking about today as a mirror to reflect for us to see ourselves in the world today we live in.
当经文里面没有写的时候，我们就要用这个原则，是不是我们是奉主耶稣基督的名。
When it doesn't explicitly tell us, then we have to ask ourselves, is this in the name of the Lord Jesus?
不是说口里说了，然后我们去做一些，做了之后我们失去基督平安的事情。
Maybe we say in our mouth and then we go and do something that makes us lose the peace of Christ in our hearts.
我们的原则是让基督的平安在我们心里做主做王。
The principle we live by is that the peace of God rule in our hearts.
我们的原则是基督的爱，让我们在万事上我们彼此包容，彼此饶恕。
And the principle we live in is that in the love of Christ that we can bear and forgive each other.
这个是基督徒的生命。
This is the Christian life.
如果亲爱的弟兄姊妹，你诚实的去审查你自己现在属灵的光景的话。
Brothers and sisters, if you sincerely search and look at your spiritual condition today,
我相信你必定会寻找到有一些我们里面有一些空间是有可以成长，有成长的空间。
That we will find in ourselves that there are places for us to grow.
可能我们生命里面有一些事情，我们是亏欠主的。
There may be some places in our life where we fall short of the Lord.
可能是羞辱主名的。
It may bring shame upon the Lord.
可能有一些人你还没有原谅。
There may be some people that you have not forgiven.
我不知道你的属灵的光景。
I don't know your spiritual condition.
但主知道。
But the Lord knows.
我的祷告就是愿意今天这个信息，神能够在你的心里做工。
That my prayer is that this message today will allow the Spirit to work in your heart.
好让我们能靠着主耶稣基督复活的大能，能够穿上这些基督的品格。
That by the power of the resurrection of the Lord, it will put on this new person.
不是靠着我们救人的力量
to put on this new strength that's not dependent upon our old person,
而是靠着这个住在我们里面的基督
but rather by the Christ that dwells in us.
我相信整个哥罗西书或者是整个新约，神有一个启示他的模式。
I'm sure that in Colossians, in the whole Bible, God has a way of revealing to us.
他先启示基督的丰富。
First, he reveals the abundance of Christ.
然后他就圣经就才告诉我们，身为基督徒，你的生活应该是怎么样的。
And then it tells us that you as Christians, this is how your life should be.
这个是一件事的两面。
This is the two aspects of the same, of one thing.
如果我们认识的基督的丰富越少，
if we fail to recognize the abundance of or for recognition of the abundance of Christ is low.
当我们的生命的活出的基督的生命也越少，
then the manifestation of Christ in our life.Is similarly low.
当我们越看见基督的丰富，而且看见我们与基督同死同复活的话，
the more we recognize that Christ, the more we recognize that we have died and been raised with Him.
当我们看见神一切的丰富都在基督里，然后我们在基督里的人也得到了这些丰富的话，
then when we recognize the fullness that is in Christ, and that we who are in Christ also are have.Are richly blessed as well.
我们的心就会越来越多的感恩。
Then more of our heart will be filled with thankfulness.
那我们就会有这个力量去原谅那些得罪我们的人。
Then we will have strength to forgive those who have wronged us.
我们会去包容那些意见跟我们不一样的人。
We could bear with people who are not the same as us.
我们的生命就会让越来的越多的彰显基督的荣美。
Then more in our life will we manifest the beauty of Christ.
这个是神的心意。
This is God's will.
我们去看第十节，三章，穿上信人之信人，在知识上渐渐更新，就在对于主耶稣的认识渐渐更新，正如照他主的形象。
三章九节，十节。Oh, put on the new self who is being renewed to a true knowledge and image of the one who created him.
所以好不好，亲爱的弟兄姊妹，我们一起有一个祷告。
Brothers and sisters, let's have a prayer.
我在这里祷告，你在家里听信息的时候，你也可以向神祈求。希望这个信息不是一个我听了一个信息，我就过去了，我就平安了，我就完成了我的任务。
I hope that you're watching from home, that you don't listen to the sermon and say, "Oh, I've done my duty. I feel good, and I move on."
我们向神祈求，求神用他的话，借着圣灵审查我们的心。
That we ask for God through His Word, through the Spirit, to really help us search our hearts.
好让我们的生命能够更多的彰显这位荣美丰富的基督。
That more in our lives that we can manifest this beautiful and abundant Christ.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
阿爸天父，我们感谢赞美你。你在创世以前，在基督里拣选了我们，使我们成为你的选民。
Abba Father, we give thanks and praise to you for before the foundation of this world that you have already chosen us in Christ.
你使我们成为圣洁的人。
You have made us a holy people.
你爱我们。
You love us.
感谢你，你让我们穿上基督。
We give thanks that we can put on Christ.
感谢你，你在基督里赦免了我们一切的过犯。
That in Christ you have forgiven us of all our transgressions.
感谢你，基督是我们荣耀的盼望。
That Christ is our glorious hope.
感谢你，基督是我们的生命。
We give thanks to you because Christ is our life.
感谢你，你一切的丰富都在基督里，我们在基督里的人也得了这些丰富。
We give thanks to you that in Christ is all of the richness, and we who are in Christ have access to this richness.
我们现在这里向你的灵祈求，求圣灵打开我们心里的眼睛。
We pray that the Spirit open up our eyes.
让我们看见我们所接受的祝福是何等的大。
That we would know, that we would recognize that the blessings that you've given us is so great.
扩张我们对你的认识。
That when it compares to our knowledge of you,
让我们更深的认识基督。
That when
更多的认识基督。
That when we more know of you, deeply more know of you,
好让我们的生命更多的彰显基督。
That more of our life will manifest Christ.
求你垂听我们的祷告。
May you listen to our prayers.
好让你的名在我们当中被高举。
That may your name be lifted up among us.
谢谢我们的天父。
We give thanks to our Heavenly Father.
荣耀赞美都归给你。
All praise and give thankfulness be unto you.
奉主耶稣基督的名祷告。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.